Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to explain you how you can write algorithm for linear search that can be applied on 1DL. So in my previous video, that was also related to several algorithms like traverse, insert and delete related to 1DL. So after watching that video, now you can easily understand how we can implement linear search algorithm that will be related to 1DL, right? So here name of algorithm will be linear search and the parameters will be a, n, item and LOC. So these four parameters are required. So here A is array with n elements, right? So n you can consider as total number of elements, those are available inside A array. Then item is the value that we need to search. So item is to be searched. So we need to search whether this item is available in the 1D array or not. And next is LOC. So LOC is the location where item is present, right? And if item is not available anywhere in the array, right? So in that case, the value of LOC will be zero. So now I am going to write the steps. So in first step, I am initializing this LOC variable with zero. So when you will be implementing a program or method for this algorithm, so you need to return the value of LOC to the caller method so that we can identify whether number was available in the array or not. So if value of LOC remains zero after completion of whole algorithm, then it means element was not found. But if the value of LOC is other than zero, it means on that particular location, whatever the value is available in LOC, the item is found, right? So this is the first step. So LOC is equals to zero. Now step number two. So step number two, I am going to initialize a loop counter. So let's say I equals to one. So in my previous video, I already told you, in case of data structure, we consider that first location of array is 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's say these are the values which are available in array. So in case of algorithm, we are considering first location as 1. But whenever you are going to implement this with the help of any programming language, or you are going to implement a method for this, so in that case, you need to start this I as 0 and LOC you can initialize as minus 1, right? So these little changes you need to do. Then after step number 2, in case of step number 3, we need to repeat a loop. So here repeat. So we need to repeat steps 3 and 4. So step number 4 and 5 will be repeated because 3 is this step. So step number 4 and 5 will be repeated. And while I less than equals to n. Right? So this is the termination condition for this algorithm. So if I is less than equals to n, then this loop will repeat. And if I is greater than n, then this loop will be terminated. Now inside this loop, we need to apply a condition. So that is if A of I equals to item, right? So we are comparing A of I. So right now A of I is one, A1 position. If it is equals to item, so it means item is found in the array. So after this, we can write set LOC equals to I. So on this location item is available and we can write exit. So exit is similar to break that we use in C programming to terminate a loop. So here we cannot use break, so that's why I'm using exit. So if item is found, so I am assigning LOC with value of I and then terminating this, right? And if this condition is false, then we need to move the loop counter to next position. So set I equals to I plus 1. So this way I will move to second position. Then again, this condition will be checked. If it is true, then that location will be assigned and loop will be terminated. And if it is false, then again I will be incremented. So this way this loop will repeat. And here I can write end of loop. Then stat number 6. So after termination of this loop, we can write exit. Now let's take an example so that we can understand it properly. So item that we are going to search is 13 and initial position of LOC is 0, right? So I is 1 starting from here and N is 6. So we need to repeat 4 and 5 step. So I is less than equal to N, so this condition is true. Now check A of I. So A of 1 position is 11 and item is 13. So it is false. So this step will not execute. Then I will be incremented. So value of I will become 2. Check this condition. It is true because 2 is less than equal to 6. Then A of 2 position, that is 12. If it is equal to item, so no, false. Again, I will be incremented. So this time value of I is 3. So again, this condition is true. Check A of 3 position. So A of 3 position is 13. Item is also 13. So this time condition is matching. So it will be executed. LOC will be assigned with value I. So I is right now 3. So value of LOC will be 3. It means at third location item is found and we need to exit this. So exit means the whole process will be terminated and your item location is 3, so you can use this LOC variable for further uses. So when you will be implementing this algorithm with any programming language, so let's say you will be implementing it with C, so you need to implement a method and that method will be returning LOC with the value or you can say with the location where that item was found. Let's say we are searching for 130. Item is 130. So 130 is not available in this array. So in that case, LOC will become 0. It won't be having any location. So in that case, LOC will be returning 0. So in caller method, where you will be calling the linear search method, you can check what is the value of LOC. If it is 0, it means item not found. If it is other than 0, so it means item was found at the location whose value is available in the LOC. So I hope with this explanation you understood how we can implement linear search algorithm for 1D array with the help of data structure. So if you want to watch more data structure and algorithm related videos or data structure implementation with C language, so you can go to description of this video where you can find links. And at the end of this video, you can also find links of those playlists. So watch those videos so that you can understand data structure well. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.